Hey, everyone, quick reminder, don't forget to check out the cool promotion down there in the video description with my affiliate partners. Canva Pro is awesome, okay? Not just for video thumbnail, but you have school presentation, work presentation. Oh, and I just got some awesome business card, great quality from Canva. Also, Chrome Burner, they have got motorcycle accessories, parts, clothing, and helmets for all your motorcycle needs. And we also have Gentle Herd, great quality products from cashmere, wool, cotton, silk. They've got socks, they've got sweaters, they've got scarves, all kinds of great items. And then also, if you're a YouTube creator, TubeBuddy, if you need help optimizing your channel, you need help growing your channel, you need help getting more views, more clicks, TubeBuddy is the tool for you. And thank you everyone in advance for taking a look. Hello, hello, welcome back to another video on the channel where healing and spiritual growth are front and center. This video shout out goes to Shift Into Abundance from over there on Instagram. Thank you for your continued support. Now, today I want to talk about gaslighting a little bit. I just need to clear a couple of things up because, again, as we are in the spiritual battle, the enemy likes to confuse everyone and convince them that only narcissists say certain things and empaths only say certain things, and that's just simply not the case. I've got some other videos, a couple short videos on what narcissists say, and there's a reason for them. I know if you go over to the video tab on the channel, you scroll down and you'll find them. It's the title of what narcissists say. It's a part one and a part two. But also, the gaslighting part. Look, this is where we gotta use that proper discernment, okay? Many of us, because remember, the empaths are getting accused of being the bad guy. We're getting accused of being the abusers. We're the one getting accused of being the narcissist. You're gonna have to get used to it, okay? Don't even pay attention to it. Don't worry about it. There's a lot of us out here. We'll step in and set the record straight as we like to do and God tells us to do. That's the bottom line right there. When God tells us to step in and intervene, we are to obey our Heavenly Father. He's telling us, and this is what He needed me to bring to your attention today. The statement, I was just joking, or I was joking, or just joking, that's not a gaslight. It's more or less their way of trying to deflect the whatever it is they said that was supposed to be a joke but really wasn't. Let's stop and think about all the perverted joke that these narcissistic abusers and the human host of demon spirit. They are very addicted to nasty, inappropriate jokes that are really not funny. All right, they're not. They are the only ones who think that's funny. It's not funny. It's gross. It's nasty. It's disgusting. And it's childish. Okay? So, it's also wickedness and plays on the mind to try to trick people into committing fornication and all of those sins that God tells us not to engage in. All right? So, stop and think about that. But if they say something like that, if they use one of those nasty jokes, and then they turn around and say, I was just joking. It's really difficult to label that as gaslighting, okay? Especially, did you get offended by it? I hope not. Many of us, no, we don't get offended by it. We just look at it, we go, really? And we don't even pay it any attention. We thwart it. It's like, no, I'm not listening to that. If it's not funny, it's not funny. So it's not a joke. But to them, it's a joke. You got to remember something. We are the entertainment for the narcissistic abuser. It's just, that's the way it is. So, we got to use logic when it comes to stuff that they're spreading around out there that are considered gaslight. And I know, now let's clarify. When that statement can be interpreted as a gaslight is when the narcissistic abuser says something deliberate to try and bring you down, that condescending. Let's say they make a condescending statement and turn around and go, well, I was just joking. Okay, then it becomes a gaslight. So that you see where that logic and discernment works together right there. All right? So always keep that in mind when you're reading information. So even though, yes, they'll use that, basically as part of the gaslight, because truth, the truth behind that is that condescending statement, that is the true gaslight. They just tack that on at the end if they don't get the reaction out of you they're looking for. See how that works? That is how they are trying to deflect. Like, okay, so that it didn't get the reaction, right? That original, like a backhanded compliment a lot of time. If they'll give a backhanded compliment and if they don't get a reaction out of you, then they'll say, I was just joking. That's their way of trying to deflect the fact that they did not get a reaction out of you. So it just becomes part of the gaslight. But that statement itself is not a gaslight per se in and of itself. It's the context. Right? So always think about that. But I also will, because here's the truth. Alchemist leaders out there, y'all know, you're going to know what I'm talking about here. You will know how our sense of humor, a lot of people don't get it. And the reason is because they're not at that level. All right? Alchemist humor is very different. And it can be taken as sarcasm, and it's not, okay? It's just a form of brutal honesty that we have. And there's only a few, but we learn who we can have that conversation with and who not to. Because we eventually get tired of having to explain to a person who, when we give a little bit of our sense of humor in there, and they just look at us like, huh? They don't get it. And we get tired of saying, that was a joke. we get tired of saying it. So we learn who we can have that so-called conversation with. And it's going to usually be somebody that's on the same level as we are. Or at least somebody who gets it. All right? Because not everybody, people are not going to get it. All right? Or that's just part of it. That's life. All right? That's life. But, so just always keep that in mind when you are doing your research going forward. To use that discernment because it's there for a reason. Because a lot of the stuff the enemy's trying to do out there is to keep people confused. And that look, and here, stop and think about it. Why do you think that the true empaths are being accused of being the narcissist, okay? It's all part of the battle because the enemy needs his flying monkeys to be viewed as the normal ones, okay? He does. That way, he could trick, admit more people into following that crowd. More people in that kind of behavior. More people into succumbing to the system of narcissism without even knowing it. The more that he can do that, the less people will find their find the kingdom of God within. Basically, again, the whole bottom line, with one of the many things that in the spiritual battle is that the enemy does not want God's children to find the kingdom of God within. And so he's doing everything he can to keep everybody off track and off of God's path. So, because when you find the kingdom of God within and you seek that first every single day, God will hasten. That's when God starts to hasten you. That's when God starts to say, okay, he sees your resilience. He sees your perseverance. He sees your dedication. You have made that commitment with the Heavenly Father that, okay, I got my purpose. This is what I'm going to do. I'm not going anywhere. Failure is not an option. And so he sees that. And he's like, okay. And once he sees that, the enemy doesn't like that. The enemy does not like that. So he wants that. It's all part of that flipping the script, as I say often, because that's what the enemy does by painting the empath as the bad guy. So that way, so bottom line is he wants to mislead as many people about what narcissistic abusers do and don't do. He wants to mislead them so that anybody that a person meets who says something like that, it's all part of that slow and subtle grooming, okay? Because he knows, the enemy knows that once that person starts to heal and get back out there in the world, that he's going to try and throw more darts their way. So he's trying to prep everybody, especially via the online world, and say, okay, let's get everybody believing what's false so that when they go back out there, They don't connect with like-minded people, and so they don't connect with God's chosen one who they belong with, who God wants them to be with. He doesn't want that connection to ever happen. So the enemy got to throw in all those little curveballs, if you will, and get people believing what is false to be true. That is the name, a big part of the name of the game in narcissism right there. So that way, let's say you come at, you're back out in the world and you come across an alchemist leader, okay, who happens to have a you know, brutal, honest type of sense of humor, just telling it like it is. And they say that, and you might not get the joke right away. And so they'll tell you, hey, that was a joke. No, you know, that was just a joke. So as soon as you hear that, the enemy has already programmed that person's mind off of all the reading about what narcissists say and da-da-da-da-da. And so that'll automatically trigger you into thinking, uh-oh, that empath, the alchemist leader empath, is not the bad guy, but the enemy's already tricked you before you even met them that's the bad guy. So I'm gonna let that sink in, okay? Because that's a lot of what's happening right now for a lot of people, because there is a lot of healing going on. There's a lot of alone time. The enemy knows that too. There's a lot of people that got to take that alone time, and there's a lot of people that are going to continue to research. And so just keep that in mind. Because that's what the enemy wants to do, is to trick you into thinking, once you're back out there, that the good guy is the bad guy. Because everybody says, you know, again, as a reminder, narcissists say they're copycats. So they say what everybody else says. I mean, where do you think they get it from? They're not original. I mean, the narcissistic abusers are not original. They have to copy everyone. It's just that simple. But back again, no, I'm not talking about those of us who are sharing ideas and we are branching out from good ideas. We share good ideas. That's not what I'm talking about. I'm talking about narcissistic abusers and these demon spirits. They have no new tricks, all right? They copy everything. And they, especially real quick, this is one of the most funniest things I have ever witnessed among the case study. And they like to do this. They come across a big word, a big brand new word that they heard from somewhere or read from somewhere. And not only do they like to use, they use it out of context without knowing, first of all, because they think it sounds cool. Right? And there's one word in particular that I remember a case study from a while back. Used to use it like all the time, and he was all excited about it. Like, my new favorite word was nuance, and I was like, okay, that's cool. I was like, okay, that's cool. But he would put it in sentences where it didn't belong a lot. All right, so that's just another little added bonus information, okay? And I know we're not supposed to be laughing or making fun of, but I cannot help but laugh at that. But that's what they do, okay? These narcissistic abusers, the demon spirits attached to the human mind, it does. It tricks that human host into doing things like that. And that's part of God, what he told us. He's like, yeah, they're going to try to profess themselves to be wise, but, you know, they're fools. I call them fumbling fools. Many of us have heard narcissistic abusers that they a lot of times don't have coherent speech. A lot of times, especially when they're mask clips. That's really the highlight of it all right there. But anyway, so that's it, y'all. Just keep that proper discernment. And as always, if you have any questions, just drop them in the comments below. Because there's a lot of information going out there. So if you need some help sorting through something and better clarification, let me know. And I will work you through that. Because we don't want you to be misled. We do not want you to be misled. Because that will also cause you to miss out on good opportunities as well. Stop and think about that. All right? Because there are still a lot of good people. There are a lot of good empaths out there. There are. But remember, because the enemy's trying to paint them as the bad guy, he's going to try to trick you beforehand mentally into thinking when you hear a certain phrase or whatever that, uh-oh, that's the bad guy, when in reality it's not. So we have to be mindful of that, okay, everyone? So, again, just drop the question in the comments below, and I'll get to them as soon as I can, all right? Sending love and light to all fellow warriors. Thank you for watching and for your support. Until next time, let's show some gratitude to the Heavenly Father, and you keep being you. In Jesus' name, amen.